Immediate changes are being made to the Accredited Employer Work Visa, which the government says will address unsustainable net migration. The most prominent change being an English language test requirement for low-skilled migrants. Now, here for their takes on the announcement is our political panel of Greens co-leader Chlöe Swarbrick and ACT Deputy Leader Brooke van Velden down the line there in Wellington. Morena korua.
Morena.
Brooke, I'll start with you.
Good morning.
I was just reading, the Immigration Minister was saying getting our immigration settings right is critical to this government's plan to rebuild the economy, yet we've classed construction workers, welders, fitters as unimportant or low-skilled workers. Is that right? And is that fair?
No, not at all. I think what you see across construction is, unfortunately, times are not looking as good as they have been in previous years. So the number of people who are needed within the construction industry is actually a bit lower than in previous years. And so you do have to rightly ask the question about whether or not we get the settings right for who is coming through the border with what skills for which industries. And so the minister has made that determination that that's no longer as needed in previous years. And these are the roles of government, that we need to be making these decisions to make sure that we've got the correct numbers for the economy at the size that we need it. I think it's a really good move, what the Minister of Immigration is making here, that we want to support Kiwi job seekers, but we also want to reduce migrant exploitation that we know has been on the increase since Labor introduced this accredited worker scheme. And so I think the moves are the right thing to do.
You heard Brooke there. Chlöe, is it the right thing to do?
Look, this is a new lick of paint on a fundamentally broken immigration system. And as constituency MPs, approximately half of the workload that we work on, particularly for me here in Auckland Central, is on immigration issues, people having challenges getting access to visas or residency pathways or otherwise. So to that effect, we would say very clearly that the single biggest thing that any government could do in order to reduce migrant exploitation is give migrants more bargaining power. That means decoupling their visa pathways from single employers. So that's something which Ricardo Menendez-March, our immigration spokesperson, has been abundantly clear on for years and years and years, and we will continue to fight for.
Brooke, is your government considering that, or would it consider that?
I know Minister Stanford will be looking at further immigration changes in the future, but I can't make any discussion here on her behalf on those matters. But if you look at what we need to do in the short term, we do have a problem in front of us. I know that there have been lots of stories of migrant exploitation. We're seeing it in the numbers as well. And we do have to act on it. That's why we're implementing more of those minimum English language tests to make sure that we have people coming into the country who have the right skills, they have the ability to do the jobs that they're being employed to do. And we know through some of the cases coming through that that's not been the case.
If I can just point out as well that we've had successive governments, both those led of red and blue stripes, that have consistently pumped up the numbers of migrants coming into the country in order to enable them to uphold the economy as we presently understand it, but they're not really looking after them when they get here. So one of the other concerning things in the announcement this past weekend from Minister Stanford is the reduction in continuous years that migrants, I believe, at level 4 and level 5 can stay in the country for. We should in fact be ensuring that migrants have a pathway to residency so that they can put down roots, build lives in their communities and contribute as New Zealanders. Whereas in fact, part of this announcement continues to contribute to that revolving door, which actually makes all of us poorer.
Is it a revolving door, Brooke?
I don't think it's a revolving door at all. I think what we need to make really, really clear is that New Zealand is a country that accepts migrants. We are a beautiful multicultural ethnic environment from all walks of life. And I think that's really, really wonderful. But what we've got to make sure is that we're getting people joining our beautiful country here who have the skills to do the jobs that are needed in our country, not people who are not necessarily matched to the job market with the skills that are needed.
Bizarre rhetoric, which seems a little bit devoid from kind of the policy settings and reality there. And again, we would just make it really abundantly clear that if you want to do the single biggest thing that would reduce migrant exploitation in this country, then we need to decouple work visas from single employers so that workers have that bargaining power.
Okay, I want to shift topics. Mm-hmm. Rugby game in the weekend. A van was shot at in Hawke's Bay, pelted with bullets.
Jeez.
That rugby game, yeah, different rugby game to what we're used to seeing.
Yeah, yeah.
So this game, an altercation happened, believed to be gang-linked. Mm. Do we need to be harder on gangs, Chlöe?
So the first thing that I would say is that the police, I just actually wanted to say to those victims, you know, all who witnessed that, that is completely unacceptable. Violence is completely unacceptable in any community in this country, and the police have made it clear that this was an isolated event with those who, you know, were involved known to each other. So moving on then to policy settings. This is where I get a little bit concerned about how political rhetoric will just take us to the space of being tough on crime, tough on gangs, but actually very light on evidence. So we have a lot of evidence in this country, including from the Prime Minister's Chief Science Advisor and from the Royal Commission of Inquiry into Abuse in State Care, which tell us where gangs come from. And they tell us, again, that if we want to reduce people getting involved in gang lifestyles, then we need to reduce poverty, we need to reduce inequality, we need to give young people pathways to get involved in society and fix the social contract.
Brooke, I'll come to you. I mean, surely we can just go watch a rugby game without the need to have to run for our lives and seek shelter somewhere because bullets are flying everywhere. What are you getting harder on crime? Oh. Is there more that your government needs to do?
I completely agree. I mean, it's scary. You know, rugby games are places for families where people should be able to take their kids and enjoy a spot of sport. I mean, everybody has been to a rugby game in New Zealand and walked away feeling either happy or sad for the team that's won or lost, but you don't expect to run away in fear that you're going to be shot at. That's unacceptable, and we should have no place for it. But I think this is also just the most recent example of crime that is affecting our community. I always talk to people who say that they don't feel safe. They don't feel safe on the streets. They're not feeling safe when they're going around shopping mall areas. They don't feel safe now at rugby games. What I think we need to be clear on, though, is we don't have all of the facts of this particular case and who particularly was involved. Yes, this government is going to be cracking down on crime. We have many policies to do this, things like banning the gang insignia, to make sure that people aren't intimidated in public, getting harder on illegal firearms and making sure that we're cracking down on illegal firearms being in the community, because there is a place for people who use them safely. That is not at a rugby game, and we do need to do more work there. And I know Nicole McKee, as the Associate Minister for Justice, has many policies in this area.
All right, Brooke, Chlöe, thank you so much for your time. That's all we've got.
So much more that could be said.
So much more. So much more. Brooke, thank you.
Thank you.